Browns losers here in Houston in the wild card round. Their season is over, 45-14. Mary Kay, just an absolutely stunning outcome against the Texans. CJ Stroud was fantastic, and I guess we'll start there. The defense, obviously, all year was the story of this team, and then in this game today, they just got absolutely torched by this Texans offense.
They really did. I think that CJ Stroud was better than even they expected he was going to be. He was on a mission. He had something to prove. He had been told for a week that, you know, that the Cleveland Browns were so good and that the Texans didn't have a chance. A lot of people in the national media picked the Cleveland Browns to win this game. They were favored here on the road. And you know what? C.J. Stroud had other plans. He was magnificent against them.
Yeah, it really looked a lot like some of what we saw last year under Joe Woods. And, you know, we heard from Myles Garrett after the game. We heard from a lot of the defensive backs as well. Clearly a lot of disappointment there from this performance that was really the defense that let this team down.
It really did. And you know what? They just did not pressure him. They did not sack him one time in this game. And it's not easy to sack him. He gets rid of the ball quickly. But he has been sacked 38 times this season. So it's not like he doesn't get sacked. He has to hold the ball to throw it as far as he does half the time. So they should have been able to get him off of his mark a little bit more. And then they went after a couple of guys on defense, and, you know, they made some hay that way. But, you know, that was just a disastrous part of the game.
Now, the other part of the story was Joe Flacco. He had two pick sixes in the second half when the Browns were trying to get back into the football game. And, unfortunately, the slipper kind of came off here on Joe Flacco's Cinderella story.
Yeah, it really did, and it's so unfortunate. It was the feel-good story in the NFL this season. He's been absolutely fantastic. He brought them to the dance, and he just couldn't get them home. And that's really sad because I think everyone wanted to see him try to go into Baltimore and see if he could beat those Ravens, his former team, on the way to the Super Bowl. It was just the feel-good story, and it just doesn't feel good anymore for anybody right now.
Well, we'll spin it forward a little bit here. Obviously, you're hoping we could have spun it forward to possibly a matchup with Baltimore next week. That's not going to happen. We have to spin it forward now into the offseason. Where does this team go from here? You know, Deshaun Watson's going to be back. We know that this core is pretty much locked up and paid. So there's still a lot of optimism going into next season, but there's going to be a lot of questions, too.
Yeah, there are going to be a lot of questions. You know, you saw Deshaun Watson standing there on the sidelines. He has to come back from shoulder surgery. Then there's another question about Joe Flacco. Do you bring him back as the backup quarterback of this football team? You've got Nick Chubb, who suffered a serious knee injury, and, you know, they have to make some decisions there and hope that he can come back strong. There's just so many things that they're going to have to deal with, and unfortunately, no one wanted to start thinking about that yet. This was the team that had the talent to go all the way. It really did. And this game just completely got away from them by a football team that wanted to avenge a huge loss on Christmas Eve where they didn't have half of their defensive starters in the game. They wanted to come out and show that this was who they were.
Yeah, and that's one more thing here. This just feels like such a missed opportunity for this team because you just never know in the NFL when you're going to get these chances. And like you said, look, this team is very talented. They have their core locked up. But again, you don't know what next year holds in this league. It is a really fickle year to year.
It really is. And, you know, once again, you know, sometimes a game just does get away from you like this. It doesn't mean that they are this much worse than the Texans, although I think this is a team on the rise, and everyone's going to have to watch out for these Texans moving forward. There's no question about that. But I just think that, you know, the game got away from them from a couple of big, huge defensive plays and Joe's turnovers, unfortunately.
All right, a stunning outcome here in the wild card round in Houston. The Browns 45-14 losers to C.J. Stroud and the Texans. We will cover everything plus locker cleanout on Sunday, the rest of the fallout from this loss, all at cleveland.com/Browns.